It's time now for Look Lakeland Local Sports and Sports. The Wayne County High School varsity baseball team continues to roll as they improved to 10-0 in region play with an 18-1 blowout in five innings over Warner Robins. Junior Luke Boykin led off the game with his 12th home run of the season. Senior pitcher Ray Townsend tossed a one hitter, struck out six in the game. Jackets punted out 19 hits in the game. Luke Boykin 3-for-4, Blake Brockington 3-for-4, Zach Thomas 3-for-4, Ray Townsend 3-for-4. Jacob Brewer, 2-for-4. Miles Starling, 2-for-4. Aiden Hall, 1-for-2. After the blowout win, we talked with head coach Justin McDonald.
You know, a lot of these guys hadn't really been in the mix of playoffs, not having them last year. And, you know, those guys being sophomores the year that we did have it. And, you know, we got 9 seniors that, you know, there's not a whole lot of playoff experience in that group. So, again, you know, I think Friday night versus Ware, that was kind of a playoff atmosphere. And, you know, we need a big crowd on Friday, especially to honor just if you're there for one reason, and that's to respect the seniors and what they've done for our program. And, you know, we're going to get every one of them in the game. And, you know, obviously every one of them has brought something to the table to help this team to get to where it is right now. But, you know, I'm proud of coming up and taking care of business and not letting the team hang around. And, you know, we got to continue to find a way to keep this going. You know, fortunate you got 2 more games and then a quick turnaround of playing on Wednesday. So maybe we continue to stay hot and I can stay out of their way. And I could probably be their biggest enemy if I try to get in their way. And we'll get them prepared mentally and physically and let them go play.
Has the time been set for the doubleheader yet on Wednesday, Wednesday?
Yeah, it's 4:30 game one. And then I guess
30 minutes after game.
Yeah, I think we're going to do 40 minutes because I think both guys may have a position player that starts game two or
and the game playing on Thursday.
It'll be 5 o'clock. 5 o'clock on Thursday.
So 4:30, 5 o'clock is the time. So
weather permitting, I saw some rain in the forecast next week. So
talk to a couple of players and ask them a question. I'll ask you, you know, what do you think is the one thing this team needs to improve on between now and a week from Wednesday, get ready for the state playoffs?
I think one of the biggest thing is making the routine play and not giving free passes, whether it's an error or base on ball or hit by pitch. And, you know, we had one blunder here. You know, Ray got a first pitch out, and then we hit by pitch, base on balls, and they ended up scoring a run in that inning. You know, in the playoffs, you can't give guys free passes, whether it's on a defensively or on the mound, not being able to command a zone. For one reason, it gives guys extra at-bats, and it turns the lineup over. You know, baseball is not – everybody, you don't have to be very smart to know that some of the better hitters are at the top of the lineup. So you want to see those guys as least as possible. And when you give guys free passes, especially in the bottom of the lineup, allow those guys to come up with runners on, that can get you in a situation that you don't need to be in. So I think that's probably one of the biggest things. And then the next thing is kind of worry about ourselves and not try to make the moment too big for us. You know, these games next Wednesday or even Friday, they're no different than the first game of the season or game 15 or game 30. So you got to continue to stay in the moment. And you know, I've said this before, we just need to worry about us and be the best version of us every day.
Again, those comments of Coach Justin McDonald. Again, the doubleheader set for this Friday. Again, that's going to be senior night, 4:30 and 7 p.m. Again, 9 seniors on this year's team. Then the state playoffs getting away a week from today as Wayne County will host Jones County. The doubleheader next Wednesday at 4:30. In the IF game Thursday at 5 p.m. New state baseball rankings out this week. Wayne County comes in at number 6 in the state. Blessed Trinity continues to hold the number 1 spot. Second is Loganville. Third is Greenbrier. Fourth is Carterville. Fifth, Stars Mill. Wayne County again comes in at number 6 in the top 10 poll. Decatur 7th, Calhoun 8th, Harris County 9th, and North Springs 10th. In the state playoffs set for a week from today, Sheffield's Trophies and Sports Shop has the region championship t-shirts now on sale. Stop by, get ready for senior night Friday and state playoff action next Wednesday. Congrats goes out to the Wayne County High School boys golf team. Again, they are region champions. They go to Okefenokee yesterday and destroy the competition as they've done all season long. 11 strokes better than runner-up Ware County at their home course. Again, freshman Brett Malloy was the low medalist with 72. Sophomore Finley Burt shot a 75. Sophomore Antonio Warbey shot a 74. Freshman Aiden Jones, 82. Also competing for the Yellow Jackets, sophomore Jacob Strickland, 84. Junior Ashton Davis, 95. Lady Jackets came in second place with a score of 301, quartered by 3 seniors. Allison Sullivan shot a 99. Emily Harris finished with a 95. And Marissa Mobley hit a 107. Also competing for the Lady Jackets was Jameson Stevens. Jackets' next match will be Monday, April 26th, when they travel to St. Simon's for a match against Glen Academy, Richmond Hill, and BC. Then the whole team will play in an away match on Tuesday, the 27th, against Richmond Hill. Second round, the state tennis tournament gets underway tomorrow as the Wayne County boys are in the Sweet 16. They head tomorrow afternoon to Woodward Academy Again, that match is set for 2 p.m. in College Park. And the boys defeated Jones County here on Monday, 4-1. Round two of that tournament set for tomorrow on the road at Woodward Academy. Again, we wish them well. And it gets underway tomorrow at 2 o'clock. State playoffs begin today for the girls and boys soccer teams. Both are on the road today. The girls are at Union Grove. That match gets underway at 5 p.m. The boys are at Locust Grove. That match at 6 p.m. Recreation scoreboard from last night in 8U softball. Odom beat the Legends 4-2. 10U softball, Gators 12, Odom 5. 10 baseball, Astros 14, Cubs 3. Braves beat Odom 14-5. Angels and Orioles tied at 11 apiece. In 12U baseball, Braves beat the Reds 10-1. Dodgers beat the Astros 3-1. 14U softball, Tigers over Long County 18-3. Braves at New York last night lost to the Yankees 3-1. Braves and Yankees again tonight here on Big Dog Country FM 105.5. That's going to do it for the latest in local sports.